श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
कृष्णा कृष्णा हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे
कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
नित्य गौरंग
कीर्तन की जय अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय श्रील प्रभुपाद की
जय
श्रील रूप गोस्वामी पाद की
जय
ओम अज्ञान तिमिरंधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुः उन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
वी वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर द नेक्टर ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन सेशन टुडे In one of the classes, we did the preface of the book. Then we went to the first shloka, Vacho Vegam, Manasa Vegam verse. I devoted probably one full class for Godas and Goswami, how we should become master of senses, not a slave of the senses. Of course, there is only one master of the senses, which is Krishna, always. And anyone who attaches himself to Krishna's lotus feet can also become master of senses because of touch with Krishna. And when we disconnect from Krishna, we become slave of our senses. As simple as that. Just like a coal, when it is in fire, it is red hot. Sometimes, pat, it falls out of the fire. Then it becomes blackish. It has no more tej. It has no more power. There is no more fire. It's not fiery. But when it is in the fire, the coal is also red hot. Similarly, in Krishna's lotus feet, engaging in devotional service, we all can be very strongly situated in our bhakti yoga. And this book is a very valuable book for the practitioners like us. It starts from restraint of the senses and it will take us to the ultimate abode of Radha Kunda. It's a very, very beautiful book. Although it's a thin book, with a few verses, but it is teaching us many valuable, practically applicable teachings. So let us proceed. This is a verse we did. We will recite the verse now.
Vacho vegam manasa krodha vegam jihva vegam udaropastha vegam येतान् वेगान् यो विषहेत धीरः सर्वामपि मां पृथिवीं सशिष्यात्
सो दिस इज द टेक्स्ट वन and I will read the translation for you. A sober person who can tolerate the urge to speak, the mind's demands, the actions of anger, and the urges of the tongue, belly, and genitals, is qualified to make disciples all over the world. So, there are six urges mentioned in this. So we began, this is a revision of what we did, because last 1 week we didn't have a class, as my spiritual master was speaking, I cancelled the class, but I'm quickly revising in the first few slides what we did. The urge to speak, as it is said here, when you talk about devotion service to Krishna, then we can avoid nonsensical, useless talk. Otherwise, we may talk so many things, as we say, blah, blah, blah. So much mundane news we can talk. We can talk about political situation. We can talk about money. We can talk about women. We can talk about sports. We may talk about, even about corona, there are hundreds of videos and thousands of videos in the net. People, the more they watch, the more they become horrified. They get nightmares. So in this way, we can get tense and we can spread tension to other people. Therefore, one should know how to use the tongue, how to speak. You will find in the early morning, the birds get up, cho-cho-cho-cho-cho-cho-cho, the birds are very much making sound in the morning, asking, where is our food? Where is our mate? It starts from there. And you will find in the same manner, businessmen are asking, where can we make more money? How is the position of stock exchange? People in the train, buses are talking about the political situation. Who will come to power? And who will be defeated? Isn't it? College students are asking about, which team won? India won or any other country, they won. So everywhere there are talks of people about so many mundane subjects. People speak about movies, movie stars. Some movie stars' marriages, it's not that without talking that, they can't continue living or something. Actually, there is so much useless gossip that goes on all across the globe. The globe is surrounded by a global gossip. And due to that urge to speak about others, there is also gossip like this, as you see here. People gossiping about so many others. So, the Prabhupada compares the gossiping people to a frog, as you see here. Actually, in a rainy season, near the shores of a bank of a river, you may find there are many holes. Those holes are actually made by rats. So the rats go and live inside. So in those holes they live, but then sometimes a snake enters the hole and eats the rat, and then the snake lives in that hole. So, in the Bhagavatam, there is a verse which says two examples. Bilebato rukrama vikramanye na shrinvata karna pute narasya jihvasati dardurike vasuta na chopagayat turugaya gatha. This says that the ears of a person which are used for hearing worldly news, politics and all these things, but who never uses the ears for hearing about Krishna. So those ears are like those holes where the snake has gone inside, eaten the rat, and snake is living there. Is that hole useful for the other rats to go inside? They cannot go inside, because if other rats go inside, who is living inside? Snakes. If the rats go inside, the snake will eat them. So no rat will go inside. So those holes are useless holes. Similarly, the holes of a human being, ear holes, when they don't use it for hearing katha of the Lord, those holes are compared to the snake holes where snakes live. Of course, inside this hole, by taking mundane information, it goes into our minds and hearts, and then it produces snake-like material desires. Therefore, they are compared to the snake holes. So the material desires for sense gratification are like a snake hole, snake. The snake sometimes it's very cold, and this body is very cold. In summer season, it will be very nice to wrap a snake around your body because you can feel warm. Huh? I mean, in summer season, you can feel cold. Is it good? But the snake has a tooth with which it can bite us. Similarly, the snake-like material desires bite us. And that what is that bite? The bhogavritti or enjoying mentality increases by hearing mundane news. In fact, even after becoming a devotee, the more we associate with the mundane news, our non-devotional propensities will increase. Asat sanga tyagye vaishnavachar stri sangi yeka sadhu krishna abhakta ar. It is said, by associating with abhaktas and then by associating with women and abhaktas and asat sanga, by that asat sanga we get very degraded, because in asat sanga you get to hear mundane news, mundane talks, useless talks, like you see this gossip here, like that. So if our ears are not snake holes, if our ears are considered to be considered glorious, then they should only take in Harikatha. That doesn't mean you cannot talk to anybody, because in the outside world, you may have to talk and they will talk to you. There are so many job related talks or academic related talks one has to do. One has to be very intelligent not to take bad association. Once you take good association. So another example given is the croaking toad. Or the tongue of the croaking toad is like here you see the frog or a toad. He was caught by the snake. How? Because in rainy season, when the snake is out, the snake is hungry. So the toad makes a sound. He makes a sound. Hearing that sound, the snake comes there. Wherever the sound is coming from. And then he catches from behind, you can see that. Similarly, people who talk with their tongue, useless talks, you know, they are compared to the frog who is inviting the snake of Kala Uraga, the snake of death, to devour them. That's the example. Yeah, and then Prabhupada says, Mauna is useless. We are not told that you completely shut up your mouth, don't talk at all. You can't keep silent for a very long time. See that fellow sitting. He's raising the hand, he wants to say something. So he may write on a board and tell others, which is as good as speaking only. So everybody has a propensity to speak. So what to do if you want to speak, Vachavegam? Okay, you can speak about Krishna. You can preach about Krishna. Like you see, Prabhupada always is cheerfully situated, giving happiness to everybody by preaching. We also saw this, Prahlad Maharaj says, Mayavad is they do Maunam Charanti and they follow Mauna Vrata and go to Himalayas. I don't want to do that. I want to deliver all the suffering souls like my friends and take them back to God, as Prahlad says. It's not the devotees keep mum. We talk, but we glorify the Lord. Then the two comparison, one comparison of the swans and the crows. The crows sit in dustbin and they are gathering some dead rat or some dirty substances. That's what they delight in. Whereas the swans live in clean places where they drink pure milk. So these are swans are compared to hamsas. Like it says, Nayatra hamsa naramantya shikshaya. So therefore, we have to follow in the footsteps of these hamsas who always delight in speaking Krishna Katha, sharing Krishna Katha. They don't delight in the mundane things of the world, which are like there are many mundane novels. There are many mundane serials in TV, mundane novels. So reading them, sharing about them, those are all compared to the crows delighting in the garbage. Even though sometimes the novels are very popular in the society, people glorify the novel. Actually, it's all mundane. Mundane means it has no power to purify our heart and take us back to God. Therefore, they are useless. Prabhupada writes there in that place how there are many people writing Adhunik Kavita, modern day poetry. There are, Prabhupada saying there are thousands and thousands of books written by thousands and thousands of authors. But even after reading all those thousands of books, people don't become liberated from this world, from all the bad habits. People don't become liberated from this world and go back to God. Those books actually keep the people stuck in the mental world only. And then Prabhupada says, there are thousands of people speaking nonsense and there are other thousands of people hearing them with no sense. And this is the way people are in this world, wasting the time talking useless mundane subjects which cannot liberate us from all the sufferings. That religion is a supreme religion which can awaken love for God and liberate you from all miseries. Tapatra unmulanam. So therefore that religion is which one? Bhagavata Dharma, Paro Dharma. Prabhupada was in America. Prabhupada said, you see, you fellows are born in America, I am born in India. We are not having classes here. I am not interested in Indian interest. You are not interested in American interest. But we both are interested in Krishna's interest. So therefore we are free from the upadis or material coverings. So we talk about the Supreme Lord who is common to all the jivas. This alone can unite all the living beings, Prabhupada said. So, in Anuvritti commentary, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur says, the material identification creates three kinds of urges. That means if I identify with my material body, I think I am a male, then I am attracted to a female. Or somebody thinks I am a female, you are attracted to a male. Whereas if I identify I am Krishna Das, then I am attracted to Krishna. Then I want to serve. Somebody is thinking I am Krishna Dasi. So she also wishes to serve Krishna, you will see that. So therefore the material identification means identifying with my place of birth, identifying with my gender, identifying with the bodily covering. I am fair, you are black, I am tall, you are short, I am fat, you are thin, I belong to higher caste, you belong to lower caste, I am educated, you are uneducated, I am rich, you are poor. So this kind of differentiation and disparity people talk about due to identifying with the body. And these are the talks which fill up this world. Waste of time, because this whole body is a perishable phenomenon. Eventually, the 20, 30, 40 years down the line, where will this body be? It will be finished. But the Atma is imperishable. So talk about the Atma. Talk about Atma's relationship with Krishna. And that is worthy of talking. Otherwise, it's a waste of time. I'll show you one verse from the Srimad Bhagavatam 11th canto, very important verse.
Paraswabhava karmani.
No, no, not this one. There's one more verse I'll show you. Yeah, this is the verse. This is 11.28.2.
Paraswabhava karmani.
Ya prashansati nindati.
Sa ashubhrashyate swarthat. Asatya viniveshatah.
Please read the translation.
Whoever indulges in praising or criticizing the qualities and behavior of others will quickly become deviated from his own best interests by his entanglement in illusory dualities.
Yes. We will become deviated from our ultimate goal of going back to Godhead. If you are going to be praising and criticizing and talking about the living beings in this world. So here he says, okay, read it quickly. Purport.
A conditioned soul desires to lord it over material nature and thus criticizes another conditioned soul whom he considers inferior.
Similarly, I am great, you are small. Like that they talk about it. I have more money, he has less money. You know, I have more following, he has less following. Like that people talk, yeah.
Similarly, one praises a superior materialist because one aspires to that superior position in which one may dominate others. Praising and criticizing other materialistic people are thus directly or indirectly based on envy of other living entities and cause one to fall down from swa-artha, one's real self-interest, Krishna consciousness. The words asati abhiniveshata, by absorption in the temporary or unreal, indicate that one should not adopt a concept of material duality and praise or criticize other materialistic persons. Rather, one should praise the pure devotees of the Supreme Lord and criticize the mentality of rebellion against the personality of Godhead by which one becomes a non-devotee. One should not criticize a low-class materialist thinking that a high-class materialist is nice. In other words, one should distinguish between the material and the spiritual and should not become absorbed in good and bad on the material platform. For example,
yeah, you understand this? Very interesting point. He says here, there are people inside the jail, there are people outside the jail. That you can compare. You can say, see, these are ideal citizens of the country. They never broke the state law, so they are outside. And those who broke the state law, they are inside the jail. But inside the jail, you should not compare, saying, see, he is in C-class jail, that fellow is in A-class jail. How wonderful. He's a more advanced person. He lives in A class jail. Fortunate fellow. No, what fortunate? A class, B class, C class, all are inside where? Jail. Similar material world, somebody goes to heaven. Is A class jail. Earth, B class jail. Hell, C class jail. So one should not appreciate the differences within the world. For somebody says, hey, he is very fair, no? Very beautiful. Huh? What fair? Either you are fair or black, both have to suffer janma, mrityu, jara, vyadi. Huh? Birth, old age, disease, death. Both have to suffer. Huh? When one gets a material body, somebody may be rich, somebody is poor. Both are suffering, old age, disease, death. Is it not true? But you can compare a jiva in the material world and jiva in the spiritual world. Hey, how fortunate that jiva is in the spiritual world, because he is free from birth, old age, disease, death, and he is serving Krishna eternally, seeing Krishna eye to eye. He is fortunate. And the jivas inside the material world are wandering here and there, suffering. So, in this way, by comparing these jivas to the liberated ones, we will aspire to become liberated. That comparison is valid. Otherwise, don't compare a high-class materialist to a low-class materialist, he is saying. That's what he is saying. For example, an honest, read that.
For example, an honest citizen distinguishes between the life of civil freedom and that of imprisonment, whereas a foolish prisoner distinguishes between comfortable and uncomfortable prison cells.
Yeah. And the next para, Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur says something very important. He says that don't separate the conditioned souls by these material differences. He says that, like for example, don't distinguish them, the communist, he's capitalist, he's black, he's white, he's rich, poor, liberal, conservative. Don't say all these things. Material life is always imperfect, he says, full of ignorance. So therefore, instead of praising and criticizing high and low features of ignorance, one should be absorbed in Krishna consciousness on the spiritual platform of eternity, knowledge and bliss. So this verse talks about talking. Parasvabhava karmani yah prashansati nindati. So if you want to get rid of this useless talk, we should absorb our mouth in talking glories of Krishna, glories of pure devotees, and ideas on how we can become Krishna conscious, how to go back to Godhead. That is the best. So he is saying material identification creates this urges. So urge to speak, urge of mind, and urge of the body. The body means three things: tongue, belly, genitals. They are in one line. And then urges of the mind. Mind means there is attachment and anger in the mind. And then urge to speak. That's why these six things are spoken. Vacha vegam, manasa, krodha vegam, jihva vegam, udara upastha vegam. Okay, when we succumb to these urges, what happens? Our life becomes inauspicious. Like we talk uselessly, gossiping, rumor mongering, uselessly debating, arguing. So we suffer, others suffer also by all this. And what is tapasya? To resist these demands is called tapasya. One who can resist these demands is called as a tapasvi. And then we can overcome the victimization by material energy, which means we will not be bound in this world. Just like a bird in a cage, you open the cage and leave the bird to fly in the sky, like that you can become atma can be freed from the body to go back to Godhead by restraining these lower natures. Otherwise, if we continue these lower natures, we have to be born again and again. So, tapo divyam putrakayena sattvam shuddhyet asmad mama saukhyam tu anantam. Rishabhadev is telling, my dear sons, if you do divine tapasya by restraining your urge to speak, then your heart will be purified and you will experience spiritual bliss, he is telling them. So, last time I showed this manasa vegam also. That was vacha vegam, till now we spoke. Now manasa vegam. The mind is very fickle. And if there is an idle mind, it attracts anarthas. Like here you see, Zagni Dara sitting in the forest and doing meditation, and Purvachiti Apsara is passing by. Immediately his eyes are open and he is getting attracted. So he is trying to use a yogic process to negate the mind of all thoughts. But then creating a vacuum in the mind will not work. Because the yogic process, you try to negate the material desires from the mind. And then try to keep an empty mind. No, empty mind will not work. It is going to fill it up with this kind of sight. So he became attracted to her and married her after that. So you will see that instead of trying to empty the material desires from the mind, we can fill up the mind with spiritual desires. So the spiritual desires go inside and kick out the material desires like that. Then your heart will become flooded with spiritual desires. So that is the point here. Please read that.
The restlessness or fickleness of the mind is controlled when one can fix his mind on the lotus feet of Krishna.
Yeah, see, the fickleness is shown in the picture below. See, the chariot has five horses, which represents the five senses. Shrotram, Chakshus, Parshanam, Rasanam, Granam. Eyes, ears, nose, skin, and tongue. Eyes, nose, tongue, and skin, and ears. Ears, yeah. So these are five senses, and mind is the middle one. So just as these five senses are connected to the mind, similarly the five horses are connected through the rope. And the mind is under the custody of intelligence, which is the decision maker in the body. So here the intelligence is driver. But the problem is, the driver, intelligence, never studied Bhagavad Gita and scriptures. So he's a very weak driver. When intelligence becomes weak, then the mind goes haywire. Then all the horses are running in different directions, you see. What is happening? That means the uncontrolled senses pull the mind, and the mind is pulling the intelligence, which is weak. Then a person degrades. See, the soul is the passenger sitting behind, he is toppling. He is suffering. So therefore people are suffering nowadays. Because of a fickle mind, uncontrolled mind, unsteady mind. So many of the people's reason for suicides, reason for increasing criminalism, all these things, the mind is the main reason. Because the mind has three prominent anarthas, kama, krodha and lobha. Based on which, out of the three, kama is the most important. I explained it very elaborately last time. Kama means the desire. When kama is not satisfied, it becomes krodha. When it is satisfied, it becomes lobha. Kama means I want, adamant desire. And lobha means I want more, that is lobha. Krodha means, why I am not getting, that is krodha. I wanted it, why I am not getting? So then one gets angry. So this kind of fickle mind is creating a hell. There is one very beautiful verse in Avanti Brahmana section, 11th canto. Mana eva manushyanam karanam. He's saying, mana param karanam amananti samsara chakram parivartayadya. Initially, the Avanti Brahman said, why am I suffering in this world? Is it due to the graha, navagrahas? He said. Then he asked, am I suffering due to kala, the time factor? Am I suffering due to my own karma? Like that, he considered all the different possibilities. Finally, he said, even if I am suffering due to karma, I did some wrong thing in the past life, but how did I do that wrong thing? The first wrong thing happens because of impurity in the mind. The mental impurity makes our body commit sin. And when we commit sin, we get bad karma. And then we suffer in this life and future lives. So therefore, he was telling, Nayam jano me sukha dukkha hetor na devatatma graha karma kalaha manapparam karanam amananti samsara chakram parivartayedya. He said, manapparam karanam amananti. Mind is the culprit, he said. Because of whom we are all suffering in this world. The impure mind is the culprit. There is one more very nice poet, Vaishnava poet, is saying, another verse I'll tell you. Bhavod bhava klesha shata hata hata indriya paribrahmana kapatantare niyam yatam madhavahe manohyaha tvadangrishankau drida bhakti bandhane. You know what he says? Bhava udbhava klesha. In this world, from Bhavasagar or the material existence, many pains are produced, klesha. Shata ahata ahata. The horse of my mind is going on the road of sense gratification very fastly. And I am running behind it and telling him, hey, don't go in the road of sense gratification. It will lead you to hell. But it is running just like these five horses. My horse of my mind is running in the road of sense gratification. And he is being whipped repeatedly by the sinful reactions which come in our life. Niyamyatam madhavahe manohiyaha. Manohiyaha means the horse mind. Please, my dear Madhava, take these ropes of this horse mind, my mind of mine, and tie it in your lotus feet. Because once it is tied to Krishna's lotus feet, the horse will become calm. Because horse requires to be tied in a pole. Similarly, my mind is like a horse, which you tie it in your lotus feet so that I am engaged in your service. Otherwise, this horse is making a hell out of my life. So So it's a fact actually, all over the world, the people are suffering terribly nowadays because of uncontrolled mind, uncontrolled anger, lust and greed. Many people have lost their cool head, many people have lost their good career because of, there are so many stories that could be said, because of lust and anger and greed, people have lost. But because of greed, man goes for bribe and corruption, isn't it? And because of lust, there are sex scandals, there are, gang rapes and things like that. And because of anger, there are murders and criminalism. See, all these modern day evils, their root is from these three anarthas only, which are residing in the mind. So therefore, and these diseases, these three cannot be satisfied very easily. There is one more verse which says, Kama dinam katina katida palita durnideshas yesham trayi na karuna na tripa na upashanti. He's saying, my dear Supreme Lord Krishna, for thousands of lifetimes, I had these three enemies, lust, anger and greed. And these three fellows are such a dangerous masters that they are keeping, no matter how much I serve them, they are not satisfied. The demands are going on increasing. Give me more. More lust, more greed, more anger. They are demanding more and more. In this world, if a man is hungry, you can give him food, he is satisfied. If a man is angry, you can allow him to shout, he will become peaceful. But if a man is greedy, nobody can satisfy him. Greed is like fire, which jumps from one place to another, expanding. So, therefore, the greedy Hiranyakashipu could not be satisfied. Greedy Ravana could not be satisfied. These people were all destroyed. Greedy Vena. So many kings were destroyed because of greed. Bhagavatam says that. So, in this way, he says, Yesham Trayi Na Tripa Na Karuna Na Upashanti. He's saying that Tripa means the lust in the mind is not satisfied. Na karuna, and it is, these three masters are not showing me compassion on me. They are telling me, work hard, give more. They go on demanding. Na upashanti, and I lost my peace of mind, he is saying, because of this. Now he says, enough now. Now I will not take shelter of these bad masters, lust, anger and greed. Instead of taking shelter of my mind, which is driven by emotion, and intelligence is driven by doubts. So therefore, the mind which is driven by material emotions should be elevated to cultivate spiritual emotions by Savai Mana Krishna Padaravindayor, by putting the mind in Krishna's lotus feet. We have to awaken spiritual emotion, otherwise the mind will terribly degrade us in this world. Mind can create a hell for us in this world. So therefore, you can see this pure devotees there, their mind is easily controlled when they fix it on remembrance of Krishna. Yeah, Krishna Surya Sama, Maya Hai Andhakar. Krishna is like the sun and Maya is like the darkness. So can you ever see darkness and sun together? Have you ever seen anywhere? Where there is sun, there cannot be darkness. Therefore, bring Krishna into your mind, then the darkness of Maya will be driven out. Maya has no place in our heart. Yeah, I have explained it more. Fickleness of the mind. You cannot negate thoughts and create a vacuum. Just like you see this person's head has so many things. He's thinking of some dollar notes and some movies that he watched, pounds, and then he's having some love and a little bit of religiosity, playing guitar. So many things are in his mind going on. In this way, people's minds have multiple scripts which they have gathered through, you know, the books they read, the movies they watch, the friendships they keep from their parents, from their teachers, from their grandparents, from their neighbors and whomever they associate with. People gather a lot of impressions in the mind. Mind is filled with multiple desires. So one cannot easily remove these things from the mind. But one very easy way to get rid of all these things is, of course, idle mind will attract anarthas, as you say. Idle man's mind is a devil's workshop, we say, no? So it will become like a workshop for the devil. But the solution is to meditate on the lotus feet of Krishna. Here you see, the Matajis are all dancing in Kirtan, it's complete absorption. Similarly, Prabhuji is going on a Harinam Sankirtan, chanting the holy name, repeating the Maha Mantra, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. It's called mantra, that which gives freedom to the mind. So, in the Vedic times also, it is a custom at home. If parents see that a son is very naughty or very rebellious, or a son is very morose, or if they see that a boy is playing cards and drinking liquor and all, oftentimes the mother will call and tell the boy, "Beta, go and meet a sadhu and come. Take some mantra and come." They will say. Why? Because they know very well, if the boy goes to temple, meets some sadhu baba and takes some mantra and comes home and chants the Lord's name in the morning because mother has told him, all bad habits will be gone. It will be finished. Prabhupada says, even a young boy in Krishna consciousness, who is just 8th or 10th standard boy, he gives up smoking, drinking, drugs, going to cinemas, playing useless games. He is ready to do away with all this. He has no inclination. Not that he is forced to give up. Voluntarily, he loses taste for them. And he leads a clean life. No meat eating, no gambling, no intoxication, no illicit sex. By taking to Krishna consciousness. On the other hand, Prabhupada saw in the West, even a doctorate student studying in a big university who is not Krishna conscious, Prabhupada saw them going for seeing cabaret dances, smoking in clubs, drinking and taking drugs. Prabhupada saw and said, just see, because they are not enlightened in Krishna consciousness, they are not taking shelter of Krishna. So no matter he acquires a doctorate or a postdoctorate fellowship, he will not be able to control his senses. So controlling mind and senses becomes easy by absorbing ourselves in Krishna consciousness, chanting the holy name, dancing, worshipping the deity. Makes it easy. Yeah, please read it.
Manasavegam, mind's demands. However, if one always thinks of Krishna and how to serve Krishna best, one's mind will naturally be controlled.
So how do we think of Krishna? For thinking of Krishna, we have to see, you in this world also, how does a boy think of a girl? Because he has seen many movies where he has seen hero, heroine in the movies. And he thinks that when he grows up, I am also like that hero, so I need a heroine. Then one starts thinking of a girl, and then they have watched many movies, they sing many songs, duet songs and everything. So a person has captured these things from the mundane movies and everything. And in his real life also, you will see, he will be repeating what he says in the movies. He will copy them, many of the things in the movie. But the real life is much different from the movie life. In the movie life, you find hero has got 20 men dancing with him, and the heroine has got another 20 ladies dancing with her. In the real life, do you get like that to dance? If you want to dance with your wife, 20, you have 20 men with you behind supporting you, and she has 20 women supporting her. It's simply a dream world. But actually, the material impressions enter our head by watching movie, and then in real life people try to imitate heroes and heroines, if you see. But instead of doing that, vidarka bhavane pratipaksha bhavanam, this is told by Patanjali. Patanjali says, if your head is filled with material vibrations, he says the best way is to remove the material heroes and heroines and substitute them by the supreme spiritual hero and heroine, which is Radha and Krishna. They are the real hero and heroine, imperishable hero and heroine. Nayakanam Shiro Ratnam, Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam, it is said. Krishna is the real hero. All other heroes become zeros in this world. They don't remain heroes at all. Why are you fascinated with the temporary heroes? Fill your mind with the pastimes of Radha, Krishna, Gopas, Gopis, cows, calves, Nanda Baba, Yashoda, Vrindavan, Yamuna, Govardhan. Hear these pastimes and let this be your meditation. Let this be your absorption. Like when we sing Vaishnava songs also, immediately we will remember the beautiful pastimes of Krishna. Yashumati Nandana Brajavara Nagara Gokula Ranjana Kana Gopi Paranadhana Madana Manohara
కలియాదమన విధాన అమల హరి నామ అమయ విలాస. When you sing these songs, immediately your mind meditates on the meaning. Yashumati Nandana, oh, he's a son of Mother Yashoda. Brajabara Nagara Gokula Ranjana Kana. He delights all the Brajabasis living in Vrindavan. Similarly, Brajajana Palana Asurakula Nashana. Oh, he protects the Brajabasis and he kills all the demons like Agasur, Bakasur, Putana and everybody. And Nandagodana Rakkavala, he's a very nice protector and well-wisher of his cows. All the cows are surrounding him always. And also, he goes to the homes of the gopis and he is a Makanchor, Navanita Taskara. He climbs on the pyramid of his friends and then he takes out the butter and distributes to his friends and monkeys. He performs pastimes like this. So by singing songs about him, then our meditation on Krishna and absorption in Krishna will increase. So we can sing songs narrating Krishna's name, form, qualities, pastimes and activities and fill up our mind. Or we can sing songs of Vaishnava songs, acharyas, begging Krishna to accept them as a servant. We can sing such songs also. Aha Prabhu Nanda Sutta Vrishabhana Sutta Yuta Karuna Kurohei Bharava Krishna, please be merciful to me. Please give me service. Please engage me in your service. You know, let me love you, let me serve you. Let me become one of your eternal associates. And I don't want to serve Maya, I want to serve you. So in this way, by singing songs, by hearing the pastimes, by taking darshan of the deities, and by chanting Hare Krishna Japam, Hare Krishna Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama Rama Rama, Hare Hare. By all these things, our mind becomes flooded with remembrance of Krishna. Prabhupada says in the night when you are going to bed, in all his contemples, when Prabhupada had that system in the early days, drink hot milk, and while drinking hot milk slowly, hear Krishna book. So Prabhupada said, if you do that while going to sleep, you will get Krishna dreams. In the night, Krishna going to forest with cows and calves, playing with his coward boyfriends, making the cows and calves eat the grasses, and then Krishna is playing on a swing, playing different type of games. All that remembrance will come. So whatever we take in, that becomes our meditation and absorption and remembrance. One boy was telling me that he went to his native place. When he went to his native place, as soon as the bus entered the village, he was thinking, oh, these are the temples in my native place, these are the shops, these are the cinema theatres. Oh, I'm feeling some kind of very closeness to my Janmasthana, to my birthplace. So as the bus was going, as soon as he reached the home, he heard some cinema song, he heard. As soon as he heard it, oh, this song I heard way back in 2003 or 2004 when I was in my village as a college boy. So immediately he remembered the song and his mouth also started murmuring the song because he knew the song before. And then immediately he thought of the movie, who was the hero, who was the heroine, what is hero saying to her and what is heroine saying to him. What is the meaning of the song? He started contemplating on the meaning. See how everything started. First he heard the tune, then he remembered the tune, then he remembered the song, then he remembered the movie, then he remembered the duet song, then he remembered what the hero sang, heroine sang. Everything came to his mind. Meditation. So after that, he saw his mind is getting polluted by many bad thoughts and suddenly he was shocked and he woke up. Now I am a devotee, I am wearing tilak, I am wearing kantimala, I am wearing chanting. Beat back and my mind is going to those things. Why? Because he was filling his mind with those sound vibrations. In the same manner, if we fill up our mind hearing about Krishna's name, chanting japa, then we can also hear Krishna's songs, Krishna's pastimes. Gradually our mind will absorb it. Like here you see the gopis were hearing Krishna Katha from Uddhava and they completely got so absorbed in Katha. In the middle of the katha, they started getting up. One gopi climbed on the shoulder of another gopi and said, "Hey, Kaliya, today I will subdue you today," she said. Another gopi
took the end of her sari and extended and said, "All of you Vrajabasis, come and take shelter of Govardhan. I will protect you from Indra's heavy rains." In this way, every gopi started narrating, demonstrating one pastime. And the Uddhava was surprised. They have become so much one with the pastimes, absorbed in the pastimes, that they are making a demo of the pastimes. They have lost external consciousness. The gopis have completely become absorbed in Krishna, Krishna's remembrance. Uddhava understood, and Uddhava fell at their feet and offered obeisances. He said, "You gopis, you are also blessed to remember Krishna at every moment in your mind. And I am, although a student of Brihaspati, a very learned scholar, chief guru of the Devatas, still I have come here to beg Krishna Prema from you." And the gopis immediately told Uddhava, "Hey, don't glorify us. We are not interested in hearing about our glories. Tell us Krishna's glories. You continue the pastime." So they were interested in hearing more and more about Krishna. Similarly, you see here, Markandeya Rishi, he saw Krishna as a Vatapatra Shai. Padaravinde kararavindam kararavinde vinivesayantam vatasya patrasya puteshayanam balam mukundam manasasmarami. He remembered this beautiful form of Krishna lying in a banyan tree leaf, a blue baby with curly locks of hair, with peacock feather. He took his own right leg thumb and put in his mouth to check, "Why my devotee is glorifying my dust of my lotus feet? Let me taste it myself and see what is there in my feet." So Markandeya Rishi saw this. That's a very long pastime, cut short. I can tell you, when he swam in that very heavy oceanic floods everywhere, his body was full of bruises and he was very pained. But when he saw the child, all his pain vanished. And he asked the child, "Who are you?" And the child didn't say anything. He smiled. And Markandeya Rishi was inhaled into the body of the child. Inside, he saw the same thing, oceans and Mount Everest and everything. He was shocked. How is the belly of the child having all the same things? What is there in the outside world? Because whole Brahmanda is inside his belly. Then again, when the child exhaled, he came out. And the child now spoke to him, "My dear child Markandeya, I am the Adi Purusha. People call me as Hari or Krishna or Vishnu. Because you are my pure devotee, Markandeya, I bless you that you will have a unfailing memory. You will always have smriti of me. And you will also live your life as long as you desire. Ichamrityu you will have." So Lord Krishna gave two benedictions to him. And then the whole scene vanished. But Markandeya Rishi never forgot this pastime. He told this to Pandavas. He said, "Oh Pandavas, don't think of this Krishna to be your cousin brother. He is Adi Purusha. He is a Sarvakarana Karanam. He is Anadir Adir Govinda." Immediately Pandavas were amazed. They all offered obeisances to Krishna immediately, hearing that. Of course, they very soon forgot Krishna's very big position because of intimate love for him. So in this way, Markandeya Rishi's mind was completely absorbed in remembrance of this Vatapatra Shai, Krishna lying in a banyan tree leaf. So you will find every great pure devotee has developed attraction for one particular form, like where Madhvacharya developed attraction for Udupi Krishna. Similarly, Tukaram developed attachment to Vittal Rukmai. Vittal Rukmini is Krishna Dwarakadish Rukmini. Similarly, Ramanujacharya developed attachment to Varadaraja Perumal in Kanchipuram, as well as to also Ranganatha and Balaji. In this way, you will find the pure devotees, their mind and heart are completely revolving around remembrance of the Lord and his pastimes, like Hanuman is the lover of Sitaram. In this way, if we think of the Lord and his pastimes, our mind will become easily controlled. Because we are withdrawing the mind from wrong engagement. Like a child sometimes goes to the kitchen and he wants to touch the fire in the gas stove. Because it is blue colored, looks like a flower. He wants to touch. Mother says, "Hey, don't touch." Then he takes a knife to put in the mouth. Mother says, "Hey, don't put in the mouth." Then the child runs outside the door. Mother comes and catches him from behind. "Hey, you cannot run outside the house." And the child says, "What is this, mom? Whatever I do, you are telling me no, no. You know, don't run outside. Don't touch the fire. You know, don't take the knife. Don't take the cooker weight and put in the mouth. Anything I do, you are stopping." So, in this way, if you tell the mind to not do this, not do that, not do that, mind will get irritated. Hey, you are not letting me do anything and I have a lot of push. I want to do something. Therefore, we have to give positive engagement to the mind. Very necessary. Man mana, Krishna says, think of me. How we can think of him? Thinking of his pastimes, thinking of his activities, thinking of Krishna's greatness, sweetness. That's the way we can keep the mind engaged in a higher platform. And we can easily give up the lower engagements, dangerous engagements of the mind. This is about urges of anger. This is next one. Achavegam manasa krodavegam. Many people try to stop anger. You cannot stop. If you suppress the anger, you will get psychological diseases inside. If you express the anger, others will cry. Because you will break down the hearts of others. What to do? Should we suppress or should we express? Then what to do? Let us see. Solution is, apply rightly to the blasphemers. You can show your anger only on Krishna Dveshi. Like here you see, Krishna is engaging Arjuna to fight the battle of Kurukshetra, Dharma Yuddha. Now fighting this battle requires anger and passion, correct? No? You can't go to battlefield and be sitting in the chariot and watching how is everything. No, heads are flying, people are dying, blood is flowing like a river. So naturally when you are in the battlefield, you'll be, people throw words, very strong words, and they send the arrows. So Arjuna's anger was engaged in establishing dharma. Similarly, Hanuman did one bonus service to Ram by putting fire to Lanka, which Lord Ram appreciated later. And you see Jagai Madai, when they are being delivered, you see in this pastime, when Lord Chaitanya heard Madai threw a pot on the head of Nityananda, Lord Chaitanya became angry. Immediately he showed the Vishnu form with chakra. He said, Madai, you have hurt my very dear favorite devotee Nityananda. I will cut off your head now. And Madai immediately caught hold of the feet of Mahaprabhu and begged him for forgiveness. He said, my dear Lord, whatever sins we did, me and my brother Jagai and Madai, we have a share in that. You know, you are giving him love of God, you are punishing me. Then Nityananda also came in between and said, my Lord, don't cut his head, please forgive him. Now, the same Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you know, he told this famous verse, Trinada Pishuni Chena Tarurapi Sahishuna, you should be as humble as a blade of grass and tolerant as a tree. Prabhupada quotes it in the purport and says that why did Lord Chaitanya say this verse? You should be very tolerant. And now he became intolerant. That is to show that when we are personally insulted, we should be tolerant. If another Vaishnava devotee is insulted, or somebody is insulting Lord or Vaishnavas, then one has to not tolerate it. One should rectify it. Therefore, Mahaprabhu showed the chakra. But he didn't kill Madai. On the request of Nityananda Prabhu, he delivered both the brothers and made them pure devotees. So, but the point remains that he brought the chakra out of anger. That's called transcendental anger. Anger is utilized positively. So these are all examples of correct application of anger. Now, let us see what Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur says about this Krodha Vegam. He uses two Sanskrit words in his book Anuvritti. One is Avirodha Preeti and Virodha Yukta Krodha, he's saying. He's saying that, just 1 minute. Hey, they're making. Okay. So, Avirodha Preeti means unrestricted attachment. Look at this lady. She has currency note in the hand and she's dreaming. How will I use this money? Oh, I can go here. I can purchase this. I can purchase that. She's dreaming. So, she's developing some attachment for something. If somebody has unrestricted attachment to the philosophy of Mayavadis or Karmavadis, and belief in the plans based on materialistic desires. The problem with material desires is what? In this world you will find, if you get one mobile, then there are better model mobiles available with better facilities. Then mind hankers for them. You get that, then you want even more better. Huh? Similarly, you got a Maruti car, you think, oh, Maruti is too simple. It's like a, you know, small tiny car. Now I want to go for a bigger car, and then even more bigger car, then a foreign car. Huh? Similarly, people who have a cycle, they want a scooter. Those who have a scooter, they want a car. Those who have a car, they want a bigger car. And people who have foreign costly cars, then they want to have their own chartered plane. Huh? You will see that it is ever increasing. The material desires cannot be stopped, and they keep on increasing more and more. People who are Lakhpati want to become Karodpati, Karodpati want to become Arapati, Arapati want to become Karapati. The desires keep increasing. So this is one reason why we become angry, because we have unrestricted attachment to enjoy, and when that endowment is stopped by somebody, we become angry. Look at the man below that lady. That fellow is very angry, looking at the computer screen. Probably something unpleasant for him, unpleasant news for him. Maybe he got some losses in his business or something. Look at his face. He looks like somebody who has drunk some castor oil or something. Isn't it? He looks extremely upset. And the other boss also, who is shouting at the subordinate with a big loudspeaker. This is an example of, this is another, virodha yukta krodha. That means anger arising from frustration. That means initially we have material attachment, material desires. When they are not fulfilled, we get the second one. Anger arises from frustration of unfulfilled desires. That means both are very bad. It's like raga and dvesha. Raga is a very strong attachment to enjoying certain things. Like Ravana, for example, went to Maricha and he told Maricha, Maricha, I am thinking of going and fetching Sita and carrying her to Lanka, so I wanted some help from you. Maricha said, wait a minute, first listen to me. He said, I became a carnivorous stag. Stag means deer. I became a carnivorous deer along with two others of my friends. And when I went to Vishwamitra's forest, we used to move like a deer, but then we would go near the sages and pounce on them and tear them to pieces and eat them and drink blood. So that kind of carnivorous deer I became. And he said, when I went to Vishwamitra's area of sacrifice, Lord Ram and Lakshman were there. As soon as we went there, because we had a flaming tongue, flaming mouth. So immediately Ram detected it, and immediately Ram sent three arrows to my, both the friends died. But myself, they died on the spot, but I fled from there very fast. And this arrow, it threw me 800 miles into the ocean, far away in the interior of the ocean. And the arrow didn't kill me, it returned back. Why? Because I ran away from the arrow. Rambaan has a policy that if anybody runs away, the arrow will not kill them. So it went back to Ram. He said, Rama is so mighty, so powerful. What can I tell you? In this forest, when I am living, when I see the big trees, they look like Rama only standing. I am very frightened. If somebody says any word starting with Ratha, immediately I remember Rama. I get very frightened. So he said, I don't want to, you know, let me tell you, whoever gave you this advice to go and fight with Rama, he is your worst enemy. So better you go back to Lanka, live with Mandodari peacefully, and Ram can live peacefully with Sita. Both of you be peaceful and I will also be peaceful. Maricha said, and what do you think Ravana did? He agreed. He went back to Lanka. And life was going on very peacefully. But then when Shurpanakha went to her brother and said, Ravan, hey brother, what have you done? You didn't listen to me. She understood that I want Ram. And in order to get Ram, I have to induce him to chase after Sita. That was her plan. Then she started telling about the beauty of Sita. So the more Ravana heard about the beauty of Sita, he became more and more lusty, attracted to her. And then again he went to Maricha second time. And he told Maricha this time, hey Maricha, I have not come here to take any advice from you. Now you just listen to my instruction. Either you do it or you die at my hands. Like that he said. And Maricha asked, what is it? He said, you go and become a deer, small, beautiful looking deer. in the Panchavati area. So you distract Ram and take him far away, then I will take away Sita and go. When Maricha said, why do you contemplate on such an evil plan, my dear king? So Ravana became very angry with him because he was attached to Sita and somebody is telling him to give up that attachment. Then Maricha said, I will give you another idea. He said, instead of me becoming deer and all that, you assume the form of Ram. And then when Ram is little away in the forest for getting something, you go there and you will look like Ram. Anyway, you have the power. And then you can take Sita and go, why do you involve me? Let me be an ascetic. And Ravana became wild. He said, hey, fool, do you think I don't have this idea? I already have the thought of this plan. As soon as I assume the form of Ram, all my bad qualities go away. I become actually a very good person. And this idea of tail looting another man's wife, idea only goes away. Similarly, when I chant the name of Ram, immediately all bad qualities go away. So I'm afraid of this name. So calling Ram or assuming form of Ram, I can't do that. Therefore, I am involving you. Now, either you die at my hands or you do this work for me. Like that he said. Then Maricha said, instead of dying at your hands, better let me die in Rama's hands. And he went, but why I am telling you, his attachment to Sita made Ravana angry. So they both are connected. Avirodha Priti means unrestricted attachment to Sita. And that created Virodha Yukta Krodha, anger arising from frustration of not getting. One becomes very angry. So this is the way the anger arises from material attachments or unrealistic expectations from others. Sometimes parents want a child to get first rank in the class. Every parent wants first rank for the child. How can every child get first rank? We don't know. So therefore our desires, we all have to check whether it is realistic or unrealistic expectations from others. Similarly, for example, somebody, say you purchased a flat or something, somebody cheated you for 2 lakh or 3 lakh rupees extra they have taken. So you become extremely angry. Hey, this flat is only 40 lakhs and they have taken 44 lakhs, 43 lakhs from me. And you become angry, you try to get the money back, that fellow is not giving the money. Now you are wondering, if he doesn't give me money, then I will beat him up. I will send some gunda and break his bones or something. Okay, it's very easy for you to beat him and break his bones. Will he keep quiet? What will he do? Then he will send somebody to break your bone also. So Chanakya says, before you can attack somebody, you have to think about, if you are living in a glass house, don't throw stones at others, he says, because others can throw stones and break your glass house. So one has to think, many times our anger becomes so outrageous, we exhibit disproportionate anger. That means for even small problems, sometimes we become extremely wild and angry. So the anger can flare up like fire. Therefore, some people may have a question, can anger be used well? You can use anger also, like mother, father may sometimes show artificial anger to make the child study. Or a teacher has to sometimes show artificial anger to control the children in the class. Sometimes the doctor may show anger to a patient who is not taking medicine properly or something. So it has a right use also, but it has to be used in a calibrated way. Like you have a regulator in a gas cylinder. If there is no regulator, there will be explosion. Similarly, anger will come out like an explosion if you don't control it. So it's a very big subject, restraining the anger. So although I showed you in the previous slide, Hanuman and Arjuna and all these personalities who used anger rightly, we have to check ourselves whether we can use the anger rightly. Otherwise, oftentimes the uncontrolled anger has broken relationships. Uncontrolled anger has made people lose very good managers, very good leaders. One may lose because of uncontrolled anger, or uncontrolled anger can lead to even destruction. It can lead to criminal activities like murder or beating or things like that. It has led to wars between countries. At a familial level, at a professional level, at a country level, uncontrolled anger has always done bad. Like you can see, Dhruvasamani became disproportionately angry with Ambarish Maharaj just because Ambarish took some few drops of Charanamrit when Durvasa had gone to take a bath. He was a guest. When he returned back, she shouted at the king saying that you are not a Vishnu Bhakta, you are a Bhakta. He said, you have taken something in my absence. I am the guest. You didn't give me the full food, full prasad, and you have taken some Charanamrit, droplets. Therefore, I will create a big demon to destroy you right now. So he created a big demon, and the result? Lord Vishnu sent his Sushan Chakra, which cut the demon to pieces. And then it chased after Durvasa Muni. He had to run from pillar to post. He had to run to Brahma Loka, Indra Loka. When he went to Indra Loka, Indra saw the Sushan behind him. He said, hey, don't even come here. Get lost, run away from here. Because, you know, if you come here, the chakra will be spreading heat on all of us. You know, because you have antagonized Supreme Lord Vishnu, nobody can help you get out of here. Same way he went to Brahma Loka, Shiva Loka, at last went to Vishnu Loka, Vaikuntha. He was sent back to Ambarish to offer obeisances and seek forgiveness. You can see that he had to really cut a sorry figure for having done such a ignoble thing. So it may happen to us also in our lives. Sometimes we show disproportionate anger, which is virodha yukta krodha. And the result would be that we have to cut a sorry figure. I am sorry. I am guilty. No, I will not do that again. Please forgive me. Or sometimes we have to write a long mail, 3-4 page mail, clarifying, wrestling with guilt and requesting the other person to forgive us. So therefore, anger shouldn't be unnecessarily vitiated, aggravated in our system. Now anger is also in the mind, as I told you. Kama, krodha, lobha. So what are the solutions we can do? One of the things for the anger we could do, we should always contemplate on pure prayers like, may the wicked become virtuous, may the virtuous become tranquil, may the tranquil become free, may those who are free render others free. Sarve janaha sukhino bhavantu, sarve santu niramaya, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kashchit dukkha bhavavet. So wish well for all living beings who are all children of God. We can contemplate on that. And also sometimes others' behavior make us angry, or sometimes our behavior makes others angry also. So when others' behavior makes us angry, we can cultivate humility, we can cultivate tolerance, we can cultivate patience. If we really want to maintain our friendship with them, we can cultivate this, we can cultivate compassion. Buddha says that don't see other people who make you angry, don't see them as wicked. See them as ignorant, he says. Because if you see them as ignorant, you will feel they are foolish and you'll feel sympathy for them. If you feel that they are wicked, you'll feel envious of them. So we, instead of being envious of them, you can feel compassion for them when somebody makes us angry. And also, you have to always check whether anybody is bringing the worst out of you or best out of you. Like one boy, Dhruva, his stepmother Suruchi brought worst out of Dhruva. And his own mother, Suniti, brought the best out of Dhruva. So you associate with people who can bring the best out of you. And those who are bringing worst out of you, keep a distance away, arms distance away from them. Because they are unnecessarily, you know, agitating your mind. Of course, you can choose not to get agitated, but somehow or other, the combination creates creating explosion. We can keep an arm's distance from them. And by keeping the distance, you will gradually grow in maturity in your life. And then later on, you'll be able to tackle them at a higher stage of maturity. Similarly, there are things what cannot be cured must be endured. One example I'll tell you. So I was telling my assistant that, you know, Prabhu, it's getting late for the train. We quickly arrange the car, you know, put the luggage in this thing. So, but he was talking on phone to somebody. And that phone call was going long enough. Then I told him, you see, if you are not coming, I am going now. So I immediately went and sat in the car. I told the driver. Then the car started slowly moving. Then the assistant came running. Then he boarded the car. But the problem was, when we reached the station, and when we climbed up the staircase, it was in 4th or 5th platform. When we got on the staircase, we saw the train was already moving fast. We could not catch it. Now we put the luggage down. Now what I should do? I can yell, I can shout, I can scream. Will that make the train come back, take a reverse gear and come back? The train gone is gone. So what cannot be cured must be endured. Okay, tolerated. Then I told my assistant, okay, chalo, now I'm sitting here. I am working in a computer. So you find out what is the next train if you have missed this train. But prior to that, several times I have experience when we both will reach the station, train will be slowly moving and we both will jump into the slowly moving train and he will say, Prabhu, we have caught the train. Huh? You see, now, so we didn't miss the train, we caught it. And that's how, if you keep doing it every time, then I told him, you can't do this in airport. Can you jump into your flying plane? You can't do that, you have to reach well in advance. So sometimes there are some people who are unpunctual. So what to do in dealing with them? It's very tough. You may be very punctual man and he may be unpunctual. So the difference or mismatch in behavior causes anger. So then we have to make up our mind. After that, what I used to do, I used to take my ticket and keep it with me and I would go ahead half an hour before the train comes. And you come later in a car and if you don't come, then I go ahead. You know? So the whole idea is, we have to find out a way how to avoid unnecessarily making the anger eat up our insides because of, you know, diseases will come because of becoming unnecessarily angry. We have to, if one wants good health, one has to learn to restrain one's anger. And also, one can use humor to, actually one can laugh it off. Just see, today also we missed the train. Hari bol. So you don't have to take it too seriously. Sometimes in life, there are things which are not in our control. What if the same train is 5 hours late, what you will do? We have no control. So therefore, when things go beyond our control, we can just laugh it off. Yeah. Like one time, somebody wrote an article against Gandhi in the newspaper. And Gandhi's well-wishers, hey, they have written an article now. We should write an article countering that article. Counter-attacking. Gandhi just laughed and said, see, if a dog, if a dog bites you, will you bite a dog back? Or if a newly purchased shoe you are wearing in the leg, the shoe bites you, will you take the shoe and bite it? You bit me now, I'll bit you now. By doing that, your mouth will get spoiled because of biting the shoe. Similarly, he said that if he is biting us and we are biting back, what is the difference between him and us? If we have to stand different from him, then we have to know, don't take trivial things too seriously, he said. Similarly, in our life also, we should know what situations are very vital for us to retaliate back and what situations are not like that. One has to think twice before acting. So therefore, it is a fact that when one becomes a devotee of the Lord, Vishnu Sahasranama says this, Na krodo na cha matsaryo na lobo na shubha matihi bhavanti krita punyanam bhaktanam purushottame. The purushottama bhaktas, who are devotees of Lakshmi Narayan, Sitaram and Radha Krishna, they don't unnecessarily show anger towards other living entities. And they never become envious of other living entities. And they never harbor malice for other living entities. Ashubha bhavana. And what do they do then? Bhavanti krita punyanam bhaktanam purushottame. They are very busy and preoccupied in their life, engaging in bhakti sukriti, devotional activities for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord. That's how we have to occupy our mind and senses and time and unnecessarily not get into trouble, becoming angry on others. So now I will take some questions now. The other three, I am going to Jihva Vegam, Udare Vegam, Upastha Vegam. Next class I will finish it. So those three I will keep it for the next class. Okay. Shila Prabhupada ki. Okay, here is a question by Dhiraj Prabhu. Okay. Demons who become one with Krishna, also jnanis who merge in Brahmajyoti, do both positions are temporary. What happens with them after that? And also for ultimate liberation, doesn't bhakti has any substitution? You see, yeah, demons go to the same place where the jnanis also go, which is Brahmajyoti. And then after a long period of time, they fall back to the material world. And how can bhakti have a substitute? Because bhakti means love of God. If you don't love God, if you have any other substitute and you go to Goloka or spiritual world, Vaikuntha, and you have to see Lord face to face, and there you serve Him, play with Him, assist Him. So how can you do all that without bhakti? How can there be a substitute for bhakti? Bhakti is a natural propensity of the jiva, and it is there in the heart of everybody. It is not that you If you go for a substitute, the substitutes are karma, jnana and yoga. You adopt those paths, all of those paths have some bad component. You know that bhakti, mukti, siddhi, kami, sakale, ashanta. They're all not peaceful. Because your bhogi wants to enjoy the world, your jnani wants to renounce the world and be peaceful himself without any relationship with the Lord. And a yogi wants ashta siddhis. So because of all these desires, they are always without peace. But if you want peace, bhakti is a natural propensity. The nitya siddha krishna prema sadhya kabu noi shravanade siddha chitte karaya udai. It is said, Krishna bhakti is not something you can induce from outside. It is already there with the soul. You just have to uncover it. Just like, for example, if I have sandesh in a box, I open the box, then you see the sandesh. Bhakti is already inside your heart. You have to just uncover it. Yeah, Govinda Gopal Prabhu is asking, if Guru is not acting as a Guru in his con, should a disciple take initiation from another Guru, or he or she can continue taking shelter in Prabhupada and Shiksha Gurus in his con? Actually, I don't know how you know your Guru is not acting as a Guru. If you feel that Guru has fallen away because he's run away with a woman, or he has misappropriated some money, or he has given up his practices, and now he has given up bhakti practice and he has become like a karmi, what is it? You have to know it properly. And also, so many people are passing rumors nowadays about so many. How far is that rumor true? You have to find out for what it is. So after you thoroughly do research and find out, if you know for sure that he is not in good standing, then you take initiation from another guru. Of course, we all take shelter of Prabhupada, even if you have a Diksha Guru also. Because Prabhupada's books are the basis for the next 10,000 years. But Diksha you have to take from another living Guru, whom you can find out. If you are not happy with one person, you can take from another. And then we have another question by Shubhanga Damodar Prabhu from Delhi. I generally spend 10 minutes a day to go through daily news to get updated about the outside world. Shall I stop it completely to protect my Silver Metal Association? Oh, yes, 10 minutes a day is not a big deal. You can know it. And also, what I do, I also know a lot of outside world news. How? There is one devotee who sends me once in 2 weeks, 5-6 pages, news, very vital news and all. He cuts and pastes and sends me. So I don't have to do the tough job of having to go through a lot of things. He only picks up the news and he puts and gives me. So in case you have somebody who can, any of your other people who can do that for you, then they do the homework for you, and not only you, many of the devotees can get the cream of the news instead of having to go through all the newspaper. Yeah. Dheeraj Prabhu is asking, this very famous verse, Akashat Pratyam Toya Mataka Chisagram, okay, Sarvadhin Namaskarha Keshavam Pratikachati. Is clear cut saying that all players, whoever we worship, goes to Krishna only. Can you please explain? What is the meaning of this? See, the word Keshava means Lord Krishna, who has long flowing, beautiful hair. Keshava. It says, Sarvadeva Namaskara Keshavam Pratikachati. That means Keshava is put in a separate position and all the Sarvadeva is put in another position. That means all devatas are subordinate to Keshava, and the worship we do for them is meant for Keshava. That's the meaning. Say, for example, the government of India levies a tax on you that you have to give 5 lakh rupees per year for your business. Now, what do you think? Why to give 5 lakhs? I'll meet some MLAs, MPs or some CMs or somebody like that, and I will only give them 1 lakh each, 3 lakh I'll give them, and I will escape from paying 5 lakhs. If one does that, is that all right? That's not allowed. Actually, the 5 lakh you are supposed to give ultimately to government. You know, even if you give these people also, that money also ultimately has to go to government only. Correct, no? So, ultimately one gives to government directly, that is ideal. But it says that even if somebody gives to demigods, demigods actually offer it all to Krishna only. And the gifts that you get from demigods are also given by Krishna. They take from Krishna and give it to you. Like for example, a child may take money from father's packet and purchase a sweet and give to father. That he has taken from father only. Similarly, demigods also take from Krishna only and give you. And whatever you give, they take it and give it to Krishna only. Therefore, ideally speaking, one worships Krishna, he is best situated. Okay. And Manikanta Prabhu is asking from Andhra Pradesh, You said that we should not involve talking mundane topics like politics, news, but in the current situation, we need to know about COVID-19 situation. Our border standoff with the China, which is a reality, can't be ignored lightly. If someone is occupying our land, can we sit silently without doing our duty? How do we know whom to vote during elections without knowing their work results? You said that this world is ignorant and imperfect, so should we give up what we have? Because anyway, we can't change this ignorant world, as material world will be created again and again with imperfections. It's like losing hope to change the world. Please correct my understanding. Okay, two questions are there by Manikanta Prabhu. See, regarding India, Indo-China war, regarding corona, there are places in internet where you will get a brief news of the whole situation. And that news is good enough for me. But do you think people stop with that? There are people watching hundreds of corona videos and getting frightened and insecure, and they are also spreading the news to others. Like some of the videos I saw in corona, where a man is sitting inside the house and outside is flying, this one, COVID is flying, you know, the COVID-19 one, big, like football size, it's flying. Basically, they're saying, don't go out, don't go out of the house, because it's flying through the window, in the glass window he's watching. So there are many things put up in the net which can frighten you, and which also swallows a lot of your time. When I am talking about avoiding them, what I essentially meant is, you know, don't spend hours and hours in this. It's not worth it. Instead, you know, take some clue from your friends or anybody where you can get brief information about what you need to know. For example, the Prime Minister of India is making some statements or a video or something like that. You got it. Okay, a few minutes, it's all right. You learned it. Similarly about Indochina war, you want to get some information, you can get crux of it in certain places in the news item. It's not that you have to go through hundreds of videos, hundreds of this. And one more thing, when you are going to the news, from here you click another one, the third one, fourth one, and you become 4, 5, 6 hours sitting with the news. And then when you get up from the computer, what happens? Your head is reeling with all that news only. The mind has become occupied with that news, and you talk about it to others. They have also seen, they talk to you, talk to others. So in this way, our absorption, samadhi is in the corona, or samadhi is in Indochina war. And that is only going to produce more disease in us, more sickness in us. It's not positive. So therefore, what I would say is, you can definitely know news about Indochina war, definitely know news about corona. One of the devotees asked a question now, 10 minutes a day, 15 minutes a day, okay. You are living in the world, you need to know the world in which you are living in, naturally. Even as a brahmachari myself, I'm a preacher, I'm also getting the news. I get once in a couple of weeks, some news is supplied to me, summary of the news. And we have some devotees specifically appointed for knowing the news daily, anything new is coming up. So they don't spend much time, 10-15 minutes is good enough. But there are people who have a habit of getting carried away by the news, carried away by the videos, carried away by the latest trends, and they lose a lot of time, and they can't be Krishna conscious. You can't do two things. If you are going to be carried away and 10 hours, 8 hours you are watching such news, you can't be Krishna conscious. That's what I was telling. But it is, you know, I agree that it's important to know what is happening in the world, because we are still having a material body. We are living in the world. We can't do without it. Okay, that was one question. Another question about the world being ignorant and material world, we can't change it again and again. If that is so, then why are we preaching? Why did Prabhupada go to America and preach? Why am I preaching? Why am I giving the lectures and everything? So you will see that if people cannot reform, then there is no meaning of Shastra only. Shastras are useless. But Sanatana Goswami says that the Jiva, due to being his Tatastha Shakti, which means he has a free will, either to choose to become a devotee of God, or choose to become a demon. He has a choice. So we are giving opportunity to people to become devotees. So we will preach. The preaching work we will do. We will glorify Krishna. We will speak from the Shastra. Even though the world will be created imperfect, you can make as many people as perfect and send them, dispatch them back to God. Just like in a jail, there is a mechanism of reformation kept. Similarly, in this world also, one of the mechanisms of reformation is the saintly people or the devotees of God should preach the message, gospel of God. It's a duty. So therefore, we should do it. And knowing the news is all right, but don't take the mundane news as your absorption. That is useless. For absorption, keep Krishna. Vinayak was asking, how and why did Markandeya live so long? Yeah, Markandeya was given a blessing for living for many millenniums. There are some sages who live in both in Ram Lila and Krishna Lila also. They live through many millenniums. Yeah. And they utilize their life also very well in Krishna consciousness, spreading great good to the people also. Vinayak was asking, sometimes I am singing or uttering arati, but it becomes difficult to think of the meaning and contemplate. Rather, the mind goes for various other things. Yeah, keep endeavoring, Vinayak Prabhu. Therefore, you have to read more about Guru, more about Narasimha Deva and Prahalad. Like when I read the whole pastime of Narasimha Prahalad, then when I'm singing Narasimha Arati, all those thoughts come in the mind. What Prabhupada says in the purports, how wonderful Lord Narasimha is, exhibited his love by protecting Prahalad. So therefore, reading Bhagavatam will help you to expand your spiritual consciousness. Rupesh was asking, does lust, anger and greed become prominent at different phases of our life? Or they are always powerful and resting in me? No, when you are a child, you will see that your attraction is for the balloon or a tricycle. When you grow up to teenage, you are attracted to a boy, you are attracted to a girl. And when you become 25, 30, 35, then you are attracted to money, making money and saving money. In this way, at different ages, we become attracted to different things. But the lust, anger and greed are dormant in, even in childhood stage also. And because we are carrying it in our mind from the Purva Janma also. Some of the things we carry from Purva Janma and some of the things we have picked up in this life. From mother, father, teachers, friends, from the different books we read, movie we watched and all that. So therefore, anyway, the mind has many impurities. It can be erased by chanting of the holy name. Regularly chanting and hearing the Srimad Bhagavatam on a regular basis, keeping in Sangha with devotees and avoiding Asat Sangha, we can easily do that. Kirtanashri is asking from Malaysia. Prabhu, I am going to Mangala Arati, Gaura Arati and doing 16 rounds, but I am feeling like doing it as a routine. How to overcome this, Prabhu? I couldn't develop attachment to Krishna. Okay. So, why it becomes a routine? Because we have a material outlook, it becomes a routine. So to have a spiritual outlook, you have to add one more element to it, which is consciousness or the spirit. In order to do that, we have to read Srimad Bhagavatam and know the characters like Akrura, how he entered Vrindavan. And in the same manner, you study about the different characters, Pandavas, read the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. Read about Prahalad, read about Dhruva. So by reading, you will see that we develop a great attraction to their prayers and everything. Then the spirit awakens in us. So when you combine spirit plus ritual, equal to spiritual. Now if you have only ritual, it is very mechanical and boring. Day after day we get bored and slowly we will stop all the aratis. We may not want to go. But when spirit is added, you can go on for 1 year, 2 years, 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, till the last breath, and you can continue it next life also. So find out how we can add the spirit by studying Srimad Bhagavatam. 5 things you can do. Sadhu Sangha Nama Kirtan Bhagavata Shravan Mathura Vasa Shri Murtira Shraddaya Sevan. 5 things. Associating with saintly people, Sadhu Sangha, Vaishnavas, and Nama Kirtan, chanting the holy name. Bhagavata Shravan, hearing Bhagavatam. And Mathura Vas means visiting the holy places like Vrindavan. Or making your home like Vrindavan with altar and everything. And Shri Murtra Shraddaya Sevan, worshipping the deity form of the Lord at home, very faithfully, with great affection. So in this way we can increase our spirit for Krishna consciousness. Also associating with very advanced devotees who have a great spirit that clings to us. It's very contagious. Yeah. And Snehal Vans is asking, from Nagar, as you talk about anger from that contest, I want to ask, is being angry on a relationship like brother and sometimes too much, so much often using bad words and getting excessive angry is good? If that anger is for his or higher good? Sorry, I know this question is not up to the mark or a little bit out of the topic. No, it's not out of the topic. It's very relevant. Because we are all in lockdown period, we were facing so much quarrels. Yeah, that's true. Actually, when brother or sister or parents are very near, we see their face morning to evening. All the time we are with them in a small house. So there may be, because we have attachment to them, we also develop anger for them. Attachment and anger are two sides of the same coin. So you may want your brother, to study well and crack the exams and get into some engineering or medical college and become glorious in his life. But he is very careless. He just wants to play. He wants to watch TV, or he is lazy. So he's not up to your mark. So one thing Snehal Mataji can know, that in this world, everybody has that free will and their free independence, and we can't completely change people. And people refuse to change very easily. And when we try to change them, they protest also. And that's what leads to anger and quarrel. And you as a sister, you may have a desire to help. Your desire is good. But therefore, what we should try to do, you can try to influence your relatives by affection first, and through providing them facility, by being kind and being helpful. And slowly we can try to change. And over a period of time, they may change. But after doing certain things, if they are not changing, then you should know that it is their fate. It is their independence. They are like that. What can we do? You have done your part. But if we become angry and we get very wild on them and we take them to task, then the result is relationship becomes very weak, and then it may sometimes become so bad that after they grow up, they want to keep away from us. So you want the relationship within a family. So we should know that we have a limit. Beyond the limit, we can't go in a person's life. To some degree, we can help. We can also pray to Krishna to help your brother, and also teach him chanting Hare Krishna. Slowly, things may change. Madhav Maharaj is asking, you said we should direct our anger to blasphemers. But what if we do not have such people in our life and are angry with immediate family members, like the children who do not listen to us? Oh, mother is naturally very attached to children and also angry with the children. These two go together. I told you, Preeti was said attachment, and then Virodhikta Krodh, anger. They both are connected, as I told you. To those whom you love very much, you have big expectation from them. So you can know that Krishna has put a few souls together in a family, husband, wife, children and all. And these souls have come from various places. We don't know where they have come from. So you should know that they are carrying their Puro Janma scripts in their mind also. So they may not be up to the mark, so we become upset with them. So we should know that in this life they are with me, and I'll try my best to coach them, train them, bring them to the right path. But beyond a certain level, if we are forcing the children, when they come to teenage, they will develop animosity towards mother and father. So I would suggest you are in Hyderabad, if you go to the ISKCON Abbots temple, the devotees, there are books on art of parenting. In Pune it's available. If you go to www.voicepunepublications.com, voicepunepublications.com, you will see the book, and there you can order. They can even parcel it to you. So if you read, there are more than 20 authors and different people have written about parenting. You will get a lot of ideas on how to parent your child, and then you will be able to lovingly parent the child and grow the child without having to exert yourself angrily. Vinay Prabhu is asking, my parents are short-tempered, they become angry and often end with a quarrel. How can I help them? They started chanting from last month. Very good. Already they have started chanting, very good. You give them some lectures, they won't have time to quarrel. Give them some lectures to hear whatever language they know. They'll become busy hearing, and then hearing characters of Bhagavatam, they will become very peaceful. How many more are there? Three more? Okay. Nowadays we see on some social media platforms, some blasphemous persons take some particular statements of Srila Prabhupada, like woman, like rape, and some statements on Shudras, and goes out of context and uses it to project him as a racist and caste system and all that. Seeing this, I become very angry, but I do not know how to answer these people. Neither I doubt that they will be willing to listen to what we tell. In such a case, what can be done? Because you told that we need to vent out our anger on the people who are offending acharyas and protect dignity of our parampara. So because these people post it in the social media. One thing, social media has become a platform now for anybody to express their voice, their concerns, freedom of thought, freedom of speech and all that. That is true. So it goes to thousands of people and they get negative. So what ISKCON is doing, when such things come up in social media, it's not that we keep mum. We have answered it. Our communication department in ISKCON has answered these questions. Probably these guys may not be knowing. But whenever such things are posted, then we also give a counter in a very polite, very good language, with reason and logic, appealing to the intelligence of the masses. So that person will be defeated. Like for example, There are Zakir Naik had raised many questions at one time, and there is an ISKCON devotee who has posted answers to all the questions. If you go to the internet, you can say Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna Zakir Naik. If you put, you will get it. So we have done that kind of devotees have done worldwide. Devotees will do it, but in case you can send me links, and I can connect it to the right devotees who will give answers. My link is you can write a mail to me at voicemedia.pune@gmail.com. You're welcome. Krishna Sripu is saying, I'm getting scared because of some black magic did to me. I'm scared of everything. Chanting helps, and even though I am scared, please help me. Yeah, don't worry, Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu. Your name is a very sweet name. You are Krishna Chaitanya Das, servant of Lord Chaitanya, who is actually bestower of love of God, and you are chanting Hare Krishna. Some people may tell you that somebody has put magic and all. You are a devotee, nothing can happen to you. If any Vaitala or anything comes to you, hearing you chanting the whole name, it will go back and attack the person who threw it on you. Don't worry. And also meet the devotees. You are in Hyderabad. We have a center in Madhapur. Also ISKCON Abids. We have a temple. So if you write to me, I can connect you. If you write a mail to me at voicemedia.pune@gmail.com. Ramesh Babu is asking from Delhi, is it all right to become angry, to discipline a person like mother becoming angry with a child? Yeah, that has to be done very moderately, with a moderate pain, moderate anger. It shouldn't become disproportionate. That we should take care. Shri Babu is asking, whenever I am criticized or criticized by others, depending on their position in my life, I either get angry, sad, or have mixed feelings due to my false ego and false prestige. How do I drop this and become a better person? Yeah. Actually, as I told you, reading Bhagavatam gives you, it dissolves your false ego. Reading Bhagavatam, it makes us humble, tolerant, patient, compassionate, cooperative, understanding, empathic. Because it actually helps us to see everybody as a child of God. So you begin with Prabhupada's small books, then you read Prabhupada's bigger books, then Bhagavad Gita, then Srimad Bhagavatam. Also, you can hear these lectures. Like this Bhagavatam first canto, I have completely spoken it in Bhagavata Rasamalayam. You will get it in the same live.radheshyamdas.com. If you click and go inside Bhagavata Rasamalayam in English, all 19 chapters of first canto, you just hear it. You will get a lot of ideas on how to, get rid of false ego and behave nicely. And we all are learning through Srimad Bhagavatam and chanting. Those two are good enough. Last question. Can you tell another verse from Shastra as a reference to exactly tell meaning of Akashat Patitam Toyam? Oh, there are many verses. Krishna says that Sataya Shraddaya Yuktas Tasya Radhana Mihate. He says that those people who are worshipping demigods. He is saying Mayaiva Bihitan Hitan. He says, ultimately Arjuna, it is me only giving all the gifts to the people through the demigods whom they worship. I give the people faith in demigods, and I give the demigods commodities to give to people. In this way, both the connection is made possible only by me. Krishna says, you will read in the 7th chapter and 9th chapter. There are many, many verses. And Krishna telling about his relationship with the demigods. All demigods are like mukhyamantris, and Krishna is like the prime minister. Everybody is dependent on him. One last question here. Okay, this is Avinash Prabhu from Latur. That's what I answered now. Okay. Keshava is single doubt, from which you can understand he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Otherwise, it should say, Sarva Deva Namaskaraha Brahma Jyoti Pratikachati. It should say, it doesn't say that. It says, Sarva Deva Namaskaraha Keshavam Pratikachati. That means Keshava is Supreme Lord and all others are subordinate. Ekala Ishwara Krishna Arasabha Bhritya. It is said, he is the Supreme and everybody else is subordinate to him. Just as we are all worshipping him, the Devatas also worship him. So we have completed the question answer. So next week when you all come, we will continue with the three vegams and we will finish. And what we learned from this verse today, Vacha Vegam, Manasa Vegam, Krodha Vegam, we have to actually not become unnecessarily angry with other living entities, because then we will get diverted from the ultimate goal of life. Because imagine, for example, somebody fought with you and went away. Your lips are quivering and your body is breathing. Then our whole attention is on the enemy only. We become enemy-centered. But if you have to become Krishna-centered, then we have to rise above these kinds of lower natures. So our mind should be cleaned up by chanting the holy name. Yannama Shruti Matrena Puman Bhavati Nirmalaha. Make the mind nirmal by Nama Shruti, by hearing the holy name. When mind is clean, then you can peacefully think of Krishna, and we will have a very cheerful disposition. So especially those who are in responsible position should very be alert and attentive, not to unnecessarily become overly angry and spoil their cool head, because a cool head is required for peaceful meditation and chanting and practice of spiritual life. So thank you all very much for your very brilliant questions as well as